the city, one speaker at a time. I'm transmitting it live, yeah. Take it over the city, one speaker at a time, and I'm transmitting it live. Powerful poetry, the voice of the block. Lyrical code for the soldier, hustle hard for the squad. Five elements, the culture, call it real hip-hop. Fresh out the boombox, never go hot. I'm reading the ballad of a big boy for the struggling grind. I'm on the streets like I'm homeless, living the rhyme. Yeah, it's one speaker at a time.
That's right.
I'm transmitting to the city of mine. In due time to shine, it's the way I'm designed. The end of your mind with the light of the truth, talk of the time. I'm defined by my mic, not the industry. Not the ministry, but the energy, the third eye.
Hey, what's going on, friends? This is Kevin Bracey live from the G5 Studios Chasing Greatness podcast. You know, friends, I was thinking today as I was driving, I was thinking back to December 4th, 2011, when I found myself standing amid 9,000 runners at the starting line of the California International Marathon. I was remembering back how my heart was beating, racing through my chest. I can feel my whole body. Every time my heart would beat, it felt like my entire body was shaking. Although I had trained 4 months previous, trained my mind, trained my body, trained my spirit, trained my soul to accomplish this task that was ahead of me. I found myself a couple of minutes before we were going to start the marathon, I found myself being gripped by fear. I found myself having absolutely zero belief that I could finish the task at hand. I couldn't spend too much time thinking about it because bang, the gun went off and 9,000 runners took off, including myself. There were many peaks and valleys throughout this run. The first peak was at mile 6, when 30 to 40 students that I was running the marathon for were standing on the corner before I was going to make a left turn headed toward mile 7, and they were cheering my name, "Brace yourself, Bracey, go, go, go." They were so excited, and it lifted my spirits. It didn't add belief. It didn't dissipate the fear. The fear did not dissipate, excuse me, but it did lift my spirits up. Mile 9, altogether different. It was my first valley. Mile 9, my body started to shut down. Mile 9, I started to cramp up. Mile 9, I wanted to quit. But at mile 9, I looked to my right, and there stood running next to me, stride for stride, my coach that came out of nowhere, Jason Harper, right next to me. "How you doing, Kevin?" "I'm okay." He said, "You see that bus that's coming towards us right now? On the other side of the street?" And I'm looking, I'm like, what is a bus in my head? What is a bus doing on the trail? He said, "That's the bus right there. It's for quitters. You want me to stop the bus for you?" And if looks could kill, he would have passed out as I looked at him out of the corner of my eyes. He said, "Kevin, listen to me." He said, "You see those kids at mile 6? I said, "Yeah." He said, 99% of their fathers have quit on them. 99% of the males in their lives have quit on them. He lifted my spirits up just a little more as he veered off and went to help somebody else and left me all by myself at mile 9. But he gave me just enough to get to mile 12. As those kids were at mile 12 cheering, "Go, Kevin, brace yourself," they were also there at mile 19. And they were also there 5 hours and 10 minutes later when I was crossing the finish line, 26.2 miles later. Folks, I had achieved a goal that I had absolutely no belief that I could achieve. Let me tell you something. If you struggle with belief, if you have a goal, dream, and you struggle with belief, I'm here to tell you, you'll never hear, I don't think you'll hear this from anybody else but me. I don't think anybody else has ever said this. Belief, my friends, is not required for achievement. For the achievement of a goal, you do not have to believe in order to achieve. We hear it all the time because it sounds good. Now, let me be clear. If you do believe, fantastic. If you have belief in you, great. If you can muster up belief, great. If you have people that believe in you, fantastic. But I'm here to tell you that belief is not a requirement. You say, "Kevin, belief's not a requirement." Then what is? Let me tell you. Number one, clarity of direction. You have to know where you're going. You got to know what the goal is and get clear on what the goal is. So when you achieve it, you know you've gotten there. The only way you know you've gotten there is if it's clear. Second, you got to have a reason to pursue the goal. And the reason is the driving force. The reason is the gas. My reason were those kids to raise money for those kids. Third, it takes CIP, consistent infinitesimal progression, or said it another way, small baby steps toward the goal in the direction that you're choosing to go in. Fourth, it takes a coach, somebody that can speak life into you, somebody who's been there before, who's done that, who can speak into you and their words affect you. And number five, it takes other people's belief. Les Brown taught me that sometimes you have to believe in other people's belief in you until your belief in you kicks in. Go get your goals. Go get your dreams. But understand, if you struggle with belief, don't let that be a reason to stop you from starting, because you can still achieve even if you don't believe. If you want to get somebody to believe in you and speak words of life into you, come see me on July 27th, Monstars of Motivation, Chasing Greatness Show, 2 shows, 2 o'clock and 6 o'clock. Tickets at monstarsofmotivation.com, monstars of motivation.com. And I'm going to be speaking belief into you that night. Belief to get to your goals. Belief to get better grades in school. Belief to have perfect attendance if that's what you shoot for. Belief for you to go back to school if you're an adult listening to this and you want to go back to school, or to increase your sales as a sales professional. Whoever you are, you're going to leave more positive than when you came, with some things to do when you leave in order to sustain and maintain the motivation that you will undoubtedly get, I guarantee it, in the space. July 27th, Monstars of Motivation, all for a great cause. It Takes Guts is the organization, because we're on a mission to find a cure for rare autoimmune disease in children. Every dollar from ticket sales goes to It Takes Guts. I hope to see you in the building. July 27th, Monstars of Motivation, 2 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Chasing Greatness. Listen, belief is not a requirement. If you do believe, fantastic. If you don't believe, clarity of direction, have a reason. Small baby steps, find a coach, and rely on other people's belief in you. Even if you only have one person that believes, that's another person. That's what's required for achievement. Got love for you. Brace yourself. Until next time, this has been Kendra Kobe and Caleb's daddy and Jessica's husband, also known to my family and friends as the Muhammad Ali of motivation, telling you belief is not a requirement, but at the same time, you have greatness within you. I'll see you on July 27th. Make it a great day. Brace. See ya.
One speaker at a time. I'm transmitting it live. Yeah. Take it over the city. One speaker at a time. And I'm transmitting it live. Powerful poetry, the voice of the block. Lyrical code for the soldier, hustle hard for the squad. 5 elements, the culture, call it real hip-hop. Fresh out the boombox, never go hot. I'm reading the ballad of a big boy for the struggling grind. I'm on the streets like I'm homeless, living the rhyme. Yeah, it's one speaker at a time.
That's right.
I'm transmitting to the city of mine. In due time to shine, it's the way I'm designed. The energy of mine with the light of the truth, talk of the time. I'm defined by my mic, not the industry. Not the industry, but the energy. Third eye sight. Brace yourself, we about to give you a vibe.